Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here. Today we're going to show you how to program a 5800 RPS wireless door or window switch. This device, RPS, stands for roller plunger switch. So unlike a contact that uses a magnet activating a reed switch, a mercury reed switch, that's how most door and window sensors work. This one is simple, one device. Instead of a magnet and a contact, you just have the contact, and the contact is activated and set off by this plunger switch. And when the door is closed, it holds down the switch, keeping the zone happy, and when you open the door, the switch pops out and activates the zone. So whereas on a surface mount device, we would normally mount it on the opposite of a door's hinge, this one goes in the frame of the door on the hinge side. So as soon as the door cracks open, the side of the door that would normally be tight to the hinge pops out or moves away and activates this switch. Switch pops out and the zone is triggered. So this is a very nice contact when decor is important and when you want to be very discreet. You wouldn't even see this device unless you had the door open and you were looking along that edge of the door that's on the hinge side. So now that we've introduced the device and how it works, we're going to show you how you can program it to your Honeywell LYNX Touch L5200 system. We have included with the sensor a CR1620 coin cell lithium 3-volt battery. And on the back side of the detector, or the contact, we have our battery holster. There is a positive symbol at the top, which indicates that this top portion is the positive contact. And right on our battery, we have a positive symbol. So what we do is we simply slide the battery in, positive side up, and that powers our device. This slides all the way through if you keep pushing it, so you just want to center it underneath the contact. From there, you have the little plastic end cap that you can use to close it up and keep so that the battery doesn't fall out. This red piece is our antenna for our wireless transmitter, and you also get this plastic straw that you can use to give some rigidity to the antenna, as you do not want this antenna to get jammed up inside of your door, which would or window, which would greatly reduce the sensor's range of communication back to the panel. Most commonly used in a door can also be used in a window. If you had a sliding window that slides up and down, you could mount this down into the bottom frame of the window. When the window comes down and holds the switch down, the sensor's happy. As soon as you open the window, the switch pops out and activates the zone. So that is how a 5800 RPS wireless recess plunger switch works. And now we're going to show you how to program it. From the home screen, just like with all our Honeywell wireless devices, first thing we have to do is go to security, followed by more and tools. And from tools, we can enter our installer code. 4112 is the default Honeywell installer code, which takes us to the screen where we can then select program. Program takes us to the panel's system programming page, and you can see we have the option for zones. Now, we have all of our program zones showing. Any zone that's programmed has a name on it. And if we continue to hit the down arrow until we see our first available new zone, we can go ahead and highlight that next available new zone and click Edit, which takes us to Zone 13's programming page. And on here, the first thing we do is we jump into the serial number box to program the serial number. You have two options to program the device. One, you simply enter the serial number displayed on the sticker for the device. 0497350, you can type that right here on the device and key it in. Now, that leaves it open to user input error. You mistype one digit, sensor will not work. So instead of typing it in, the better way to enroll it, which both verifies we're enrolling it properly and verifies functionality of the device, is to activate the device 3 times. So we close our door, push our switch in, open our door, which releases the switch. There's an internal spring, so it always wants to be popped out unless something's holding it tight. So that's one activation. Now we do that again, close the door, pop it open. Now we have activation number 2, which puts in our serial number, which we can see does in fact match the sticker on the sensor, 0497350. And one final activation, door closed, door open, has input the serial number and the loop number on our zone parameter page for zone 13, and we're ready to tell the system what this sensor will be. So device type is the next selection we want to do, and we can choose door or window. Obviously you see other options, glass break, smoke detector, motion, not applicable for this style sensor. So in our case, we're going to put this in our back door, and we're going to hit door, and we're going to name it back door. So instead of just being a generic zone 13 door contact, we want to say where in the house the door is. So we hit B,
back,
and we hit the down arrow until we see the word back. Now we can click done, and we have our back door set up. And the next thing we want to select is our response type. So for a door, you typically have one of two selections: entry exit 1 or perimeter. Entry exit 1 means this is an entry door. This is a door that we either enter or exit the property when the system is armed. In this case, you would have a delay, meaning when you arm the system, you have time to exit the property through that door without causing an alarm. Same idea, when you enter the property through that door, you would have so many seconds to get to the keypad and disarm the system. In our case, we do not ever use the back door unless the system is disarmed. So in that case, if it's armed and the door opens, we don't want a delay because we don't want a criminal to have time to enter the property before the main siren goes off. So by selecting perimeter, we're telling the system that if this sensor is activated, it should set off the alarm immediately. So door perimeter type is what we're using for our back door. Alarm report is a toggle option to tell the system, should I send alerts on this zone to the central station, yes or no? In our case, the system is monitored, and we do want this sensor to be monitored, so we select yes. Chime will say if when the door is opened in the disarm state, whether the system will make a noise. In our case, we do want it to chime, so we leave it standard. And then supervision is the last question. Supervision tells the sensor, if we're set to supervise, that means that the panel will check for this device every 12 hours. And it knows to check based on the serial number. So it knows it should have a zone 13, and every 12 hours it will say, hey, zone 13, are you there? If zone 13 checks back, yes, I'm here, the panel's happy, moves on to the next zone. If any zone is not seen during that 12-hour check, you would get a trouble message on the particular zone indicated as an RF supervision trouble. And then you know that you either have a range issue, perhaps were installed in a metal door, and the metal frame of the door is blocking the signal from the transmitter, or perhaps we've ignored our low battery alarm and now the battery's died inside the sensor, and so it's not being seen by the device. But any reason that this device is not being seen by the panel will be indicated as a supervision trouble, and having it supervised will tell you, will make sure that the system alerts you to that as soon as possible. Saving that selection locks in all of our changes, all of the selections, and we now see we have a zone 13 back door. And the final step is to verify that our programming worked. So we exit to our home screen, and now we simulate, before we install it, we simulate our door closed. Okay, system ready to arm, that makes sense. With all doors and windows shut, you should be able to arm the system. But let's say we had left the back door wide open. Open the door.
Back door.
Opening the door triggers a fault message, which we heard as a chime, a voice chime. It actually spoke the word back door. Shows a visual fault indication of the door open in the top left corner. You have your not ready to arm at the top in yellow, so that if you went to try to arm the system, you're going to be highlighted to the fact that your back door is left wide open, and before you can arm it, you have to go close your door. Now we have our arm away and arm stay options again. With the door closed, we can arm the system. So that verifies that our Honeywell 5800 RPS wireless recess plunger switch has been properly programmed to our LYNX Touch L5200 system. We hope you've enjoyed this video, and we invite you to subscribe to our channel. If you have any questions on programming your wireless sensors to your LYNX Touch, or any questions at all, please email us support@alarmgrid.com.